We have started interviewing, sir, yung mga police na ito, sir. They are now in Camp Crame. The other, sir, are ongoing, sir, yung ano, ang motu proprio investigations ng mga, yung balance, sir, ng data na ito.
Bigyan mo nga kami ng profile, ano, yung Sarango. Mostly, ano ba yung mga na-involved na, sa mga shenanigans pagdating sa yung drug-related operations, particularly, yung kasi yung focus ng ating inquiry dito,
yes,
sa Senate.
The data I have now, sir, is that the police commission officers involved, sir, 196. The police non-commission officers involved, sir, more or less around 210. But this being updated, sir.
No. Sa PCO muna, sa 196, ilan yung senior superintendent o kung merong chief superintendent, ilan yung inspector?
We have sa data namin, sir, January 2016 to August 17, 2016. There are no police chief superintendents involved. Zero, sir, ang aming data doon.
Yung pinakamarami na lang, huwag mo na isa-isahin. Anong pinakamarami, most prevalent na ranggo?
Ano yung police pinaka? Senior inspector, sir, at 62.
Yun ang pinakamarami?
Yes, sir.
Sa PNCOs?
Sa PNCO, sir, PO1 at 81, sir.
PO2, ilan?
42, sir.
PO3?
48, sir.
Now, that leads me to my next question. Yung ating recruitment program, kasi it appears, no, base na rin sa nakikita natin, kahapon, mga lumabas na mga suspects sa Antipolo, sa Pasay, PO1, PO2, hindi ba? So, there must be something wrong with the recruitment program. Kasi mga bagong recruit, if not the recruitment program, probably yung basic training na binibigyan natin sa mga bagong recruit. Bakit ang babata pa, sila yung pangkaraniwang na-involve? So, sige, pakinga. Paano ba kayo nagre-recruit? Paano ba kayo nagte-train? At ano yung supervisory mode na ginagawa ninyo dito sa mga bagong police?
Sir, that would lead me to another challenge that we want this Senate to address. Yung control po ng PNP over the training of PNP personnel. Sa ko muna ko sa training. Sir, we would like to inform you that tayo lang po, ang PNP lang po ang police agency sa buong mundo na hindi nagtitrain sa kanyang sariling police na pumapasok.
Sino nagtitrain sa mga police natin?
That's PPEC, Your Honor. Another agency outside of the PNP.
Madam Chair,
Philippine
I'd like
Public
to,
Safety College.
To interject with the indulgence of Senator Lacson. I agree with General De La Rosa. In fact, we have a bill that's pending now in the Senate that will transfer the admin and operational control of PNPA to the PNP. To PNP, sir.
No, PPSC or PNPA lang?
No. Under PPSC, there are several institutions, sir.
So it's only the PNPA that PNP will be transferred to the
yes,
PNP.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Di ba yung PNPA under ng PNP? Kasi ang superintendent dyan, PNP officer?
No, sir. No, Your diba? Honor. Niloan lang natin yung superintendent doon sa kanila, but they are not under our control. PPEC pa rin nagkocontrol okay. Sa kanila, Your Honor.
Ah, okay. So, Yosek Kakoy, you want to say something?
PPEC is one of the bureau under the DILG, sir. And under the PPEC are the following offices, the PNPA, the PNTI, which trains the new policemen, the PO1. There's also the National Police College. So these are under one bureau outside the PNP, sir.
Anyway, saan committee ba na-refer yun, Sunny? Kung sa akin, I will attend to that. Ano, that much I can promise you. I will attend to that immediately.
Thank you, Your Honor.
And I agree with you. Kung wala kayong control sa training, pati sa recruitment. Sa recruitment, of course, dumadaan sa DP, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Pero in training, is left to another unit, another yes, agency. And the PNP has no say whatsoever.
Yes, Your Honor. the most that we can do as far as the training is concerned is only recommendatory in nature. We recommend to the PPC what we want to be done in the trainings of our own people. But if PPC doesn't accept our recommendation, then wala po kaming control sa kanila. So that is why we strongly recommend, Your Honor, that ibalik po ninyo sa amin yung control over this training institution. Ibalik natin sa PNP.
Noted and well taken.